How to design spandrel or coupling beams in ETABS. The spandrel, coupling or link beam as we often called it, that connects the in-between walls when there is a wall opening due to door or elevator doors, or as per the code defines, refers to as a wall section in between the vertically aligned openings, is sometimes taken for granted by the structural designer. Like any other structural member, the spandrel or coupling beam should also be designed and checked thoroughly by the structural designers. This is to ensure that flexural forces and shear forces developed more importantly on these coupling beams should be resisted accordingly. But before we go on, we invite you to subscribe if you haven't yet, and press the notification bell for you to be notified immediately once we uploaded a new video. The design of spandrel, coupling, or link beams using ETABS can be summarized in the below procedure. 1. Assign spandrel labels in coupling or spandrel walls. Before proceeding with the spandrel labeling, make sure that the wall openings have been modeled accordingly. To model wall openings in ETABS, you can go through our previous video for the tutorial, which was linked to the description below. Once the wall openings have been set, run the model to proceed. Already analyzed and run ETABS model, we begin with defining spandrel labels by going to define spandrel labels. Add new name to setup names for spandrels. To assign the spandrel labels to the wall and considerations, select the spandrel wall above the elevator openings in case of a core shear wall, and assign the spandrel labels. For a detailed explanation of how to assign spandrel labels, visit our previous article posted on our website, Pier and Spandrel Labeling for ETABS Shear Wall Design. On how to assign spandrel wall labels in ETABS, link to the description below. 2. Design of spandrel or coupling beam. Once all the spandrel labels have been set and assigned, select the spandrel beam that you want to design. Go to Design. Shear Wall Design. Start Design Check and ETABS will start the Design Check analysis. Be sure that the correct design combinations as per ultimate load combinations prior to this have been all set accordingly. You can review the design combinations used in the design by going to Design. Shear Wall Design. Select Design Load Combinations. To review the design preferences set in designing the spandrel or coupling beam, go to Design. Shear Wall Design. View Revise Preference and countercheck the parameters needed in the design. 3. Interpreting design results. The interpretation of ETABS design results in spandrel beams is then be performed after it finishes the design check analysis as previously mentioned. Select the spandrel beam into consideration once more or press the Get Previous Selection icon, Ctrl plus J, to select the previously selected spandrel beam. Once selected, go to Display. Show Table. And tick the Shear Wall Spandrel Summary under the Design tab, and click OK. The tabulated summary of the spandrel beams will appear. You can extract this table by right-clicking on the row of the table, and click Export to Excel. A table, showing on your screen will be extracted. This table will give you detailed information on the area of reinforcements needed in the top and bottom of the spandrel beam. It will give you also the required shear reinforcement needed. In the event that error messages are shown, investigates the spandrel beam and the need of increasing the thickness of it. 4. Detailing of reinforcements. The recommended typical reinforcement detail of the wall opening should be detailed in accordance with Figure R18.10.7 of ACI 318-14. The same can be interpreted accordingly in the following sketches. it is noticed that diagonal reinforcements should be placed as shown to beef up the strength of the spandrel or coupling beam. However, the number of the top and bottom rebars and the spacing of stirrups or link reinforcement varies according to the ETABS output results, as per the top rebar, bottom rebar, and shear bars respectively as analyzed and referred to previously. What do you think about this video? If you learned something new, please comment, like, and share. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.